New England is odd in that New Hampshire has no legal commercial striped bass fishery. We have a sport fishery, small, and but it's a known fish, especially among fishermen. And I think in Rhode Island, people are selling it. In Massachusetts, people are selling it in restaurants. But in Maine and New Hampshire, where we're all connected by the same water, we're not selling it.
My name is Dr. Linas Kenter. I am a postdoctoral researcher here at the University of New Hampshire. The research we're doing is laying the foundation for a striped bass aquaculture industry in the United States.
I'm Brendan Vesey from Botanica Restaurant and Gin Bar in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. So we have this fish that everyone knows about. They know it's delicious, they want to buy it. So the prospect of a cultured striped bass would be amazing.
We're working to establish this industry by describing the available genetic strains. Because of the life history of striped bass, there's these different geographic strains that are all under different natural selection pressures and therefore exhibit different traits when you grow them intensively or in tanks or net pens. The nature of the striped bass life history is that they're spawning in fresh water, they're going out into the ocean again, full strength salt water, migrating up and down the coast through every temperature that they can possibly find. And that is neat because it translates into culture systems that allow you to grow them in any environment. We are able to look at them in tanks where we can completely control the temperature and the photo period and therefore simulate what they would be experiencing as close as possible in a net pen. That kind of versatility that translates from their natural life history is really useful in culture. By surveying all these strains for potential in farming, we can kind of save a farmer or interested company years and years of research and development.
So I love rockfish and striped bass. When I grew up in Virginia, we called it chicken fish because it's so mild, very versatile, similar to chicken. So this fish can be grilled, it could be, you know, breaded and pan fried, it can be crispy skin cooked like a salmon, it could be roasted. So I like that versatility in a fish to get multiple preparations. Today we worked with the cultured striped bass from UNH. I made three preparations with the striped bass today, one whole grilled fish. And then we also did some cornmeal crusted fish, like a fish and chip style thing, and a more Botanica style dish, which was like a skin on crispy fillet with tar bay, white beans, some marinated cherry tomatoes, and a romesco sauce. You have a lot of people who either fish or someone in their family fishes for this recreationally. We're answering this challenging seafood question in what I feel is a sustainable fashion with also recognizable product. We're not trying to sell a farm-raised fish that has nothing to do with our local food shed. So people already know about this fish, they know it's in the water, but we're not taking one out of the water in order to sell to them. And so having a fish they can feel good about, that they recognize, that's also flavorful, I think we would be excited about it.
Over the past few years, we've studied many different environments to try and describe how and where striped bass can grow the best. We've looked at them in stable water temperatures all year round. We've looked at them in freshwater, brackish water, and full strength seawater. And then most recently, with the support of Sea Grant, we've done simulated marine net pens. Even though temperatures got into the low teens Celsius during the winter, striped bass were still feeding perfectly fine. A lot of net pen fish don't feed at all during certain times of the year, so knowing that there's a species that can feed and grow all year round in that range of temperatures and salinities is very promising for an industry.